Daily morning prayer. Wednesday, October 2nd, 2024. The Lord is in his holy temple. Let all the earth keep silence before him. Let us humbly confess our sins to Almighty God, Almighty and most merciful Father. We have erred and strayed from your ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against your holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done, and we have done those things which we ought not to have done. And apart from your grace, there is no health in us. O Lord, have mercy upon us. Spare all those who confess their faults. Restore all those who are penitent, according to your promises, declared to all people in Christ Jesus our Lord. O grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may now live a godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Grant to your faithful people, merciful Lord, pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins, and serve you with a quiet mind, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Praise the Lord. In the Lord's name be praised. The mercy of the Lord is everlasting. O come, let us adore him. O be joyful in the Lord, all you lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with a song. Be assured that the Lord, he is God. It is he that has made us and not we ourselves. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. O go your way into his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him and speak out of his name. For the Lord is gracious, his mercy is everlasting, and his truth endures from generation to generation. The mercy of the Lord is everlasting. O come, let us adore him. I will give thanks unto you, O Lord, with my whole heart. I will speak of all your marvelous works. I will be glad and rejoice in you. Indeed, my songs will I sing of your name, O Most High. When my enemies are driven back, they shall fall and perish at your presence. For you have maintained my right and my cause. You sit on your throne judging right. You have rebuked the nations and destroyed the ungodly. You have blotted out their name forever and ever. As for the enemy, their destruction has come. They are in perpetual ruin, like the cities which you have destroyed. Their memory has perished with them. But the Lord sits enthroned forever. He has prepared his seat for judgment. For he shall judge the world in righteousness and minister true judgment to the peoples. The Lord will be a defense for the oppressed, even a refuge in the time of trouble. And those who know your name will put their trust in you, for you, Lord, have never failed those who seek you. Oh, praise the Lord who dwells in Zion. Tell the peoples what things he has done. For when he takes vengeance for blood, he remembers them and forgets not the cry of the poor. Have mercy upon me, O Lord. Consider the trouble I suffer from those who hate me. O you who lift me up from the gates of death, that I may tell of all your praises within the gates of the daughter of Zion. I will rejoice in your salvation. The nations have sunk down in the pit that they made, in the same net which they hid secretly as your foot caught. The Lord is known to execute judgment. The ungodly are trapped in the works of their own hands. The wicked shall return to the grave, even of all the peoples that forget God. For the poor shall not always be forgotten. The patient hope of the meek shall not perish forever. Rise up, O Lord, and let them not have the upper hand. Let the nations be judged in your sight. Put them in fear, O Lord, that the nations may know themselves to be merely human. Why do you stand so far off, O Lord, and hide your face in the time of need and trouble? The ungodly in his pride persecutes the poor. Let him be taken in the crafty schemes that he has imagined. For the ungodly has boasted of his own heart's desire. The covetous holds the Lord in contempt and blasphemes his name. The ungodly is so proud that he cares not for God, neither is God in any of his thoughts. His ways are always grievous. Your judgments are far above, out of his sight, and therefore he defies all his enemies. For he has said in his heart, I shall never be cast down. No harm shall happen to me. His mouth is full of cursing, deceit, and fraud. Under his tongue are ungodliness and vanity. He sits lurking in the thievish corners of the streets, and in his hiding places he murders the innocent. His eyes are set against the poor, for he lies waiting secretly, even as a lion lurks in his den, that he may ravish the poor. He ravishes the poor when he gets him into his net. The innocent is crushed and humbled before him, and the weak cannot stand against his might. He has said in his heart, God has forgotten. He hides away his face, and he will never see it. Arise, O Lord God, and lift up your hand. Forget not the poor. Why should the wicked blaspheme God while he says in his heart, you, O God, do not care? Surely you have seen it, for you behold ungodliness and wrong, that you may take the matter into your hand. The poor commits himself unto you, for you are the helper of the fatherless. Break the power of the ungodly and malicious. Search out his ungodliness until you have brought it all to light. The Lord is king forever and ever. The nations have perished out of the land. O Lord, you have heard the desire of the poor. You prepare their heart, and your ear hearkens to it, to help the fatherless and poor with justice. Let the one who is of the earth may terrify no more. To help the fatherless and poor with justice. Let the one who is of the earth may terrify no more. In the Lord I put my trust. How then can you say to my soul, flee as a bird unto the hill? But behold, the ungodly bend their bow and make ready their arrow upon the string, that they may secretly shoot at those who are true of heart. For the foundations will be cast down, and what can the righteous do? The Lord is in his holy temple. The Lord's throne is in heaven. His eyes consider the poor, and his eyelids try the children of men. The Lord tests the righteous, but the ungodly and those who delight in wickedness, his soul abhors. Upon the ungodly he shall rain snares, fire and brimstone, storm and tempest. This shall be their portion to drink, for the righteous Lord loves righteousness. The upright shall behold his face. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the first book of Kings, beginning with the 16th chapter, the first verse. Now the word of the Lord came to Jehu the son of Hanani against Baasha, saying, Since I exalted you from the dust and made you leader over my people Israel, and you have walked in the way of Jeroboam and have misled my people Israel into sin, provoking me to anger with their sins, behold, I am going to burn down Baasha and his house, and I will make your house like the house of Jeroboam the son of Nebat. Anyone belonging to Baasha who dies in the city, the dogs will eat, and anyone belonging to him who dies in the field, the birds of the sky will eat. Now as for the rest of the acts of Baasha and what he did and his might, are they not written in the book of the Chronicles of the Kings of Israel? And Baasha lay down with his fathers and was buried in Tirzah, and his son Elah became king in his place. Moreover, the word of the Lord, through the prophet Jehu, the son of Hanani, came against Baasha and his household, both because of all the evil that he did in the sight of the Lord, provoking him to anger with the work of his hands, by being like the house of Jeroboam, and because he struck it. In the 26th year of Asa king of Judah, Elah the son of Baasha became king over Israel at Tirzah, and reigned for 2 years. And his servant Zimri, commander of half his chariots, conspired against him. Now Elah was in Tirzah drinking himself drunk in the house of Arza, who is in charge of the household in Tirzah. Then Zimri came in and struck him and put him to death in the 27th year of Asa king of Judah, and he became king in his place. And when he became king, as soon as he sat on his throne, he killed all the household of Baasha. He did not leave a single male alive, either of his relatives or of his friends. So Zimri eliminated all the household of Baasha in accordance with the word of the Lord which he spoke against Baasha through Jehu the prophet, for all the sins of Baasha and the sins of his son Elah which he committed, and into which they misled Israel, provoking the Lord God of Israel to anger with their idols. Now as for the rest of the acts of Elah and all that he did, are they not written in the book of the Chronicles of the Kings of Israel? In the 22nd year of Asa king of Judah, Zimri reigned for 7 days in Tirzah. Now the people were camped against Gibbethon, which belonged to the Philistines. And the people who were camped heard it being said, Zimri has conspired and has also struck and killed the king. Therefore all Israel made Omri, commander of the army, king over Israel that day in the camp. Then Omri and all Israel with him went up from Gibbethon and besieged Tirzah. When Zimri saw that the city was taken, he went into the citadel of the king's house and burned the king's house over himself with fire and died because of his sins which he committed, doing evil in the sight of the Lord, walking in the way of Jeroboam, and in his sin which he committed, misleading Israel to sin. Now as for the rest of the acts of Zimri and his conspiracy which he carried out, are they not written in the book of the Chronicles of the Kings of Israel? Then the people of Israel were divided into two parts. Half of the people followed Tibni, the son of Jinnah, to make him king. The other half followed Omri. But the people who followed Omri prevailed over the people who followed Tibni, the son of Jinnah. And Tibni died, and Omri became king. In the 31st year of Asa, king of Judah, Omri became king over Israel and reigned for 12 years. He reigned for 6 years at Tirzah. And he purchased the hill Samaria from Shemer for 2 talents of silver. And he built on the hill and named the city which he built Samaria after the name of Shemer, the owner of the hill. Now Omri did evil in the sight of the Lord and acted more wickedly than all who were before him. For he walked entirely in the way of Jeroboam the son of Nebat and in his sins. And in his sins into which he misled Israel, provoking the Lord God of Israel to anger with their idols. Now as for the rest of the acts of Omri, which he did, and his might which he displayed, are they not written in the book of the Chronicles of the Kings of Israel? And Omri lay down with his fathers, and was buried in Samaria, and his son Ahab became king in his place. Now Ahab, the son of Omri, became king over Israel in the 38th year of Asa, king of Judah. And Ahab, the son of Omri, reigned over Israel in Samaria for 22 years. And Ahab, the son of Omri, did evil in the sight of the Lord more than all who were before him. And as though it had been a trivial thing for him to walk in the sins of Jeroboam, the son of Nebat, he married Jezebel, the daughter of Ethbaal, king of the Sidonians, and went and served Baal and worshipped him. So he erected an altar of Baal at the house of Baal, which he built in Samaria. Ahab also made the Asherah. So Ahab did more to provoke the Lord God of Israel to anger than all the kings of Israel who were before him. In his days, Hiel the Bethuelite rebuilt Jericho, and he laid its foundations with the loss of Abraham, the firstborn, and set up its gates with the loss of his youngest son, Segub, in accordance with the word of the Lord, which he spoke by Joshua the son of Nun. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. We praise you, O God, we acclaim you as Lord. All creation worships you, the Father everlasting. To you, all angels, all the powers of heaven, the cherubim and seraphim sing in endless praise. Holy, 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 Lord God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. The glorious company of apostles praise you. The noble fellowship of prophets praise you. The right robed army of martyrs praise you. Throughout the world, the Holy Church acclaims you. Father of majesty, unbounded, your true and only Son, worthy of all praise. In the Holy Spirit, advocate and guide, you, Christ, are the King of glory, the eternal Son of the Father. When you took our flesh to set us free, you humbly chose the virgin's womb. You overcame the sting of death and opened the kingdom of heaven to all believers. You are seated at God's right hand in glory. We believe that you will come to be our judge. Come then, Lord, and help your people. Bought with the price of your own blood, and bring us with your saints to glory everlasting. Save your people, Lord, and bless your inheritance. Govern and uphold them now and always. Day by day we bless you, praise your name forever. Keep us today, Lord, from all sin. Have mercy on us, Lord, have mercy. Lord, show us your love and mercy. For we have put our trust in you. And you, Lord, is our hope. Let us never be put to shame. A reading from the first epistle of St. Peter, beginning with the first chapter, the first verse. Peter, an apostle of Jesus Christ, to those who reside as strangers scattered throughout Pontus, Galatia, Cappadocia, Asia, and Bithynia, were chosen according to the foreknowledge of God the Father by the sanctifying work of the Spirit to obey Jesus Christ and be sprinkled with his blood. May grace and peace be multiplied to you. Blessed be the Lord. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who, according to his great mercy, has caused us to be born again to a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, to obtain an inheritance which is imperishable, undefiled, and will not fade away, reserved in heaven for you, who are protected by the power of God through faith for a salvation ready to be revealed in the last time. In this you greatly rejoice, even though now for a little while, if necessary, you have been distressed by various trials, so that the proof of your faith, being more precious than gold, which perishes though tested by fire, may be found to result in praise, glory, and honor at the revelation of Jesus Christ. And though you have not seen him, you love him. And though you do not see him now, but believe in him, you greatly rejoice with joy inexpressible and full of glory, obtaining as the outcome of your faith the salvation of your souls. As to the salvation, the prophets who prophesied of the grace that would come to you made careful searches and inquiries, seeking to know what person or time the Spirit of Christ within them was indicating as he predicted the sufferings of Christ and the glories to follow. It was revealed to them that they were not serving themselves but you in these things which now have been announced to you through those who preached the gospel to you by the Holy Spirit sent from heaven, things into which angels long to look. Therefore, prepare your minds for action. Keep sober in spirit. Set your hope completely on the grace to be brought to you at the revelation of Jesus Christ. As obedient children, do not be conformed to the former lusts which were yours in ignorance. But like the Holy One who called you, be holy yourselves also in all your behavior, because it is written, "You shall be holy, for I am holy." If you address as Father the one who impartially judges according to each one's work, conduct yourselves in fear during the time of your stay on earth, knowing that you were not redeemed with perishable things like silver or gold from your futile way of life inherited from your forefathers, but with precious blood as of a lamb unblemished and spotless, the blood of Christ. For he was foreknown before the foundation of the world, but has appeared in these last times for the sake of you, who through him are believers in God, who raised him from the dead and gave him glory, so that your faith and hope are in God. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel. He has come to his people and set them free. He has raised up for us a mighty Savior, born of the house of his servant David. Through his holy prophets, he promised of old that he would save us from our enemies, from the hands of all who hate us. He promised to show mercy to our fathers and to remember his holy covenant. This was the oath he swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship him without fear, holy and righteous in his sight all the days of our life. You, my child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare his way, to give his people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of their sins. The tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us, to shine on those who dwell in darkness and in the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to his death. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and a life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. O Lord, show your mercy upon us, and grant us your salvation. O Lord, guide those who govern us, and lead us in the way of justice and truth. Clothe your ministers with righteousness and let your people sing with joy. O Lord, save your people and bless your inheritance. Give peace in our time, O Lord, and defend us by your mighty power. Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten, nor the hope of the poor be taken away. Create in us clean hearts, O God, and take not your Holy Spirit from us. O merciful Lord, grant to your faithful people pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins and serve you with a quiet mind. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. O Lord, our Heavenly Father, Almighty and Everlasting God, you have brought us safely to the beginning of this day. Defend us by your mighty power, that we may not fall into sin nor run into any danger, and that, guided by your Spirit, we may do what is righteous in your sight, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty and everlasting God, who alone works great marvels, send down upon our clergy and the congregations committed to their charge the life-giving spirit of your grace. Shower them with the continual dew of your blessing, and ignite in them as well as the love of your gospel, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O God and Father, creator of heaven and earth, have mercy upon us. O God, the Son, redeemer of the world, have mercy upon us. O God, the Holy Spirit, sanctifier of the faithful, have mercy upon us. O Holy, blessed, and glorious Trinity, one God, have mercy upon us. Remember not, Lord Jesus, our offenses, nor the offenses of our forebears. Neither reward us according to our sins. Spare us, good Lord, spare your people whom you have redeemed with your most precious blood, and by your mercy preserve us forever. Spare us, good Lord, from all evil and wickedness, from sin, from the works and assaults of the devil, from your wrath and everlasting condemnation. Good Lord, deliver us from all blindness of heart, from pride, vanity, and hypocrisy, from invasion and malice, from all lack of charity. Good Lord, deliver us from all disordered and sinful affections, and from all the deceits of all the flesh and the devil. Good Lord, deliver us from all false doctrine, heresy, and schism, from hardness of heart and contempt of your word and commandments. Good Lord, deliver us Our land here in time us from earth we find, flood from plague, pestilence, and famine, good Lord, deliver us. From all oppression, conspiracy, and rebellion, from violence, battle, and murder, and from tending suddenly and unprepared, good Lord, deliver us. By the mystery of your holy incarnation, by your holy nativity and submission to the law, by your baptism, fasting, and temptation, good Lord, deliver us. By your agony and bloody sweat, by your cross and passion, by your precious death and burial, good Lord, deliver us. By your glorious resurrection and ascension, by the sending of the Holy Spirit, by your heavenly intercession, by your heavenly intercession, and by your coming again in power and great glory, good Lord, deliver us. In all times of tribulation, in all times of prosperity, in the hour of death, and in the day of judgment, good Lord, deliver us. We sinners beseech you to hear us, O Lord God, that it may please you to rule and govern your holy church universal in the right way. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To limit all bishops, priests, and deacons with true knowledge and understanding of your word, and that both by their preaching and living they may show it accordingly, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To send forth laborers into your harvest, to prosper their work by your Holy Spirit, to make your civic health known all to all nations, and to hasten the coming of your kingdom. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To give all your people increase of grace to hear your word with humility, to receive with pure affection, and to bring forth the fruit of the Spirit. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To bring into the way of truth all who have erred and are deceived. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To give us our heart to love and fear you, and diligently to keep your commandments. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To bless and keep all your people. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord. That it may please you to rule the hearts of your servant, our national leaders, and all others of authority, that they may do justice and show mercy and work humbly before you. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To bless and guide all judges, giving them grace to execute justice and to maintain truth, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To bless and keep our armed forces by sea and land and air, to shield them at all dangers and adversities, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. Bless and protect all who serve the communities by their labor and learning, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To give and preserve for us and for others the bountiful fruits of the earth, so that the harvest we all may enjoy them, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To make wars to cease in all the world, and to give to all nations unity, peace, and concord, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. That it may please you to show mercy on all prisoners and captives, refugees, the homeless and the hungry, and all those who are desolate and oppressed, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To preserve all who are in danger by reason of their work or travel, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To strengthen the bonds of those in holy matrimony, to uphold the widowed and abandoned, and to comfort all his homes, torn by strife, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To protect the unborn and their parents, and to preserve all women in childbirth, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To care for those who have lost children or face infertility, and to provide for young children and orphans, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To visit the lonely and those who grieve, to strengthen all who suffer in mind, body, or spirit, and to comfort with your presence those who are failing and infirm, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To support, help, and deliver all who are in danger, necessity, and tribulation, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To have mercy upon all people, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord, that it may please you to give us true repentance, to forgive us all our sin, negligence, and ignorance, and to endure us with the grace of your Holy Spirit, to amend our lives according to your holy word, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to forgive our enemies, persecutors, and slanderers, and to turn their hearts, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To strengthen those who stand, to encourage the faint-hearted, to raise up those who fall, and finally to beat down Satan under our feet, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To grant to all the faithful departed eternal life and peace, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To grant that we may attain to your heavenly kingdom, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. Son of God, we beseech you to hear us. Son of God, we beseech you to hear us. O Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us your peace. O Christ, hear us. O Christ, hear us. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. O Lord, arise and help us and deliver us for your name's sake. O God, we have heard with our ears, and our forebears have declared to us the noble works that you did in the days and in the time before them. O Lord, arise and help us and deliver us for your name's sake. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O Lord, arise and help us and deliver us for your name's sake. From our enemies, defend us, O Christ, graciously behold our afflictions. With pity, behold the sorrows of our hearts, and mercy, forgive the sins of your people. With favor, hear our prayers, O Son of David, have mercy upon us. Be pleased to hear us, O Christ, graciously hear us, O Christ. Graciously hear us, O Lord Christ. Let us pray. Look mercifully, O Father, on our infirmity. Look mercifully, O Father, on our infirmities, and for the glory of your name, rescue us from all those evils that we now endure. And grant that in all our troubles we may put all our trusting confidence in your mercy, serving you in holiness and purity of life, to your honor and glory through our only mediator and advocate, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for your immeasurable love and the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days, through Jesus Christ our Lord. To whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications to you, and you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will grant their requests. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen.